Hello and welcome to this tutorial. In this video, I'm going to show you how to create a really impactful duotone effect in Illustrator. Now, this effect is usually done in Photoshop, but guess what? It's actually super easy to pull off in Illustrator too. And once you have this set up, it's even easier than Photoshop to edit and explore color combinations. We're also going to add a halftone effect to give the overall aesthetic a bold, graphic look that's perfect for adding some creative flair. So whether you're a beginner or a pro, stick around because this tutorial is going to help you get some bold, graphic effects in your work. So let's get into it. So here I am in Illustrator and these are some duotone image effects I have created earlier. Here you can see many color variations you can create. If I zoom in here and scroll across, you can see that in this instance, I have the effect applied to some wildlife imagery. Also, above my samples, I have an easy to access color palette with lots of high contrast samples, which makes it very easy to pick some combinations to use. Also, I have all these colors saved in the swatches panel ready to use. So here I have a vast amount of colors and combinations I have placed together to make this easy to use and also save me a lot of time. In this video tutorial, we are going to look at how we can create 6 unique duotone color effects. We are going to use this image of a pug and convert it into a duotone effect in Illustrator. If you want to take a closer look at this Illustrator document with all the samples and get hold of the quick sample palette, you can acquire this file as part of the poster design ebook. However, if you just want to get hold of the colors for free and get hold of this pug image and use the Duotone Swatch Library to follow along, you can find the link in the description. So to create this effect in Illustrator, we are going to cover the following steps. So be sure to check the bookmarks in this video so you can jump back or ahead at any time. Step 1, document setup. So to begin, I'm going to set up a document. I'll come up to File, New, I'll hit Print, then come over and set my canvas size. For this tutorial, I'm going to set up a custom size document to demonstrate the effect. I'll set the units to pixels. I'll type in 1000 for width and 1000 for height. For artboards, I'm going to set this to 6. I'm going to leave the color mode set to CMYK, and I'll explain why shortly. And with that set, I'll click OK. Next, I'll come into my artboards panel, hit the menu, hit the Rearrange All Artboards, and I'll set this to 3 columns with a spacing of 200 pixels, and click OK. Step 2, prep colors. So with my document set up, the first thing I'm going to do is source some colors. To make this easy, I can do one of two things. I can come into my previous document, which I prepared earlier, select all the colors, copy them, come into my new document and just paste them all in and position them above my canvas area like so. Or I can open the Duotone Swatch palette. Once you have downloaded the Swatch file, simply come up to Swatches, click the menu, down to Open Swatch Library, click Other, navigate to the Duotone samples, and click OK, and you should see them in their own panel, like so. For now, I'm just going to drag this into my side menu. Step 3, set the base layer. So once I have my colors ready, I'm going to come over to the Tools menu, grab the Rectangle Shape tool, come into the first canvas area, and just draw a box to fill the canvas area, like so. Next, I'll press I on the keyboard to activate the Eyedropper tool, and I'll come and select a color from one of my samples above, and here I'll start with this light yellow, or I'll come into my Duotone Swatch Library and click on a light yellow. And that will create my base layer. So with my first shape selected with the selection tool, I'll press Command plus X on Mac or Control plus X on PC to cut. And then I'll press Command plus Alt plus Shift plus V on Mac or Control plus Alt plus Shift on V on PC. And that will then paste my layer back and also duplicate it across every artboard. Next, I'm going to select each new shape with the selection tool and press I to activate the eyedropper and select a different base color from above. Or simply click each shape and select a base color from the Duotone Swatch Library. And just like that, I've set up 6 background tones super easy. Next, I'll jump into the layers panel, double click on my new layer and call this base. So once I have a light color applied to each shape, it's time to source and prep the image. Step 4, prep the image. So for this demonstration, I'm going to use this image of a happy little pug. Now, the only drawback about this effect is that to create it, you're going to need a black and white image of a subject and for it to be cut out. To create this effect properly, we're going to need to prepare a high contrast black and white image set on a white or transparent background. Now, this isn't easy to come by, so we're going to need to use Photoshop. So let's see how we can do this. So here I am in Photoshop, and I have the image of the pug ready. What I can do here is come over to the rectangle marquee tool, I'll draw a selection around it, and up in the control panel, I'll click select and mask. With the quick selection tool active, up in the control panel again, I'll click select subject, and Photoshop will do its best to select the pug. In this case, because there is fur involved, I'll also hit the refine hair button. With a refine selection, I can click OK in the bottom right corner, and a selection will be made around the pug. With the new selection, I can come over to the layers panel, and at the bottom, I can click the add layer mask button. Upon clicking, I have now added a layer mask and cut out the pug. Perfect. Next, I'm going to come to the bottom of the layers panel and hit the adjustment layer and select black and white. Back down to the adjustments layer again, this time I'm going to add a levels adjustment layer, and I'm going to tweak it to punch out some of the blacks. Now keep in mind, you have to be really careful when you toggle the levels. You want to avoid oversaturating the blacks and whites. The goal here is to get as much contrast as possible, but at the same time, maintain as much detail as possible. In the download folder that comes with the Duotone Swatch Library and the pug image, you will also find a PSD with a contrast sample. If you open this, you can see a good example of the type of contrast you want to aim for. Try and get some solid blacks in certain details and maintain some gray shades. Try not to push the contrast so much that you get a lot of pure white and blacks, as this will impact the effect that we will get later on. What I always try and do is get some rich blacks with some lighter tones and some nice grays. For example, here in the eyes, I have some solid blacks and I have maintained some of the detail in the face. If I push this up too much, there will be too much black and we will lose detail. So on the left here is what you want to strive for. Once happy, I'll press Command A on Mac or Control A on PC to select all. Then I'll press Command plus Shift plus C on Mac or Control plus Shift plus C on PC to copy everything. Then I'll hop back into Illustrator, come over to the layers panel, hit the plus icon at the bottom to create a new layer, and I'll name this image. I'll paste to bring in my pug image, and I'll scale down to place on my first canvas area like so. Step 5, apply Duotone effect. So next we want to turn this pug into a color. What we're going to do next is use this image as a mask. So with the image selected, I'm going to come over to the image trace panel, click on the drop down and hit shades of gray. This is just going to take the raster image and convert it into vectors. Once this has been processed, I can come up to the control panel and click expand. Then I'll select the direct selection tool, click and drag over one of the corner points and just press delete to remove the white space from around it. Next, I'll just come to my base layer and select the base layer beneath my image. I'll copy this. Then I'll click back on my image layer and press Command plus Shift plus V on Mac to paste in place. And this will place the shape on top of my pug image. I'll right click, scroll down to arrange and set this to back. With the shape still selected, I'll press I to activate the eyedropper and come and select a darker tone from my colors above, or select a color from the Duotone Swatch Library. Then I'll just come over to the layers panel, hit the lock icon on the base layer. With the selection tool, I'll click and drag over my two new layers to select them both, and then over in the transparency panel, I'll click make mask. And then I'll hit the invert mask button. This will then use the black and white vector image of the pug as a mask for the color layer, and now we can see the Duotone effect has been applied. Now with the mask layer selected, in the transparency panel, I'll then come up to effect, scroll down to pixelate, then come and select color halftone. For the max radius, I'll hit 15 and click OK, and that will apply a nice halftone effect. Keep in mind, if we come to the appearance panel, we'll be able to click back into the halftone effect and change the max radius to toggle the complexity of the halftone effect. For example, I'll just set this to 25, but for my case, this is a bit too much. So I'll pop this back to 15, and in the transparency panel, I'll click on the left thumbnail and click off to deselect, and that is our Duotone effect applied. Now you may be wondering, why did I set this document to CMYK and not RGB? So a quick note on this. What I have found is that when applying this halftone effect in RGB, the dot effects don't look as intended. For example, if I come over and change the color mode to RGB, we can see that the halftone effect appears quite different, with a lot of overlapping dots. But if I come back and change it to CMYK, the halftone effect is applied there the way I would prefer. So I have found that the best results when using this effect is to do it in the color mode of CMYK. Step 6, create color permutations. Now applying color permutations is really easy and quick. Check this out. If we click back on the pug, this time press X to cut, then press Command plus Alt plus Shift plus V on Mac, or Control plus Alt plus Shift plus V on PC, we can then paste back and duplicate across each artboard. Then I can easily select the next pug, make sure the left thumbnail is selected in the transparency panel, press I to activate the eyedropper tool, and simply select a new color from above or from the Duotone Swatch Library, and that will change the color. I'll press V to activate the selection tool, select the next pug, press I to activate the eyedropper tool, and click another color from above, or choose another color from the Duotone Swatch Library, and I'll do this for each pug, and soon I have 6 different versions of the same pug, but with different Duotone effects applied. And if I want to change the combination, I can do one of 2 things. I can either click to unlock the base layer, and click to lock the image layer, select one of the squares on the base layer, press I to activate the eyedropper tool, and simply select a base layer color, or choose a color from the Duotone Swatch Library, lock the base layer, select the image layer, and choose another color. Or I can unlock the base layer and the image layer, and with the selection tool, I can select them both, come up to Edit, come down to Edit Color, then across to Recolor Artwork. Upon click, a menu will appear, and we can then toggle the handles on the color wheel. As you do this, you will see the Duotone effect change. We can also come up to Generative Color, click on the prompts, and Illustrator will generate some additional color combinations we can choose from. Step 7, apply gradient effect. Now, this Duotone effect doesn't just work on solid colors. It can also work really well with gradients too. So now if we come to the base layer and lock the image layer, we can select a base layer and choose a gradient from above. And if we come and click on the gradient tool in the menu, we can click and drag to change the direction. And depending on which gradient we use, we will also need to come and click the image and change the tone. Step 8, export samples. So once you have your samples, you're going to want to export them. To do this, we can come up to File, down to Export, and choose Export for Screens. Upon click, a menu will appear, and from here we can choose which artboards we would like to export. Here we can export all or choose a range. For the format, I like to push this up to get lots of detail, so I'll push this up to 4. I'll set the format to PNG, choose a destination to export, click export, and there I'll have my images ready to use elsewhere. And if we look at these in Photoshop, we can see that we have lots of detail in the halftone effect. Perfect. So that is how you can create a Duotone halftone effect in Adobe Illustrator. Pretty easy, right? I really like how flexible this can be. Well, in my next video, I demonstrate how you can create this effect to create a screen print poster design in Illustrator. If you're interested to learn how to create a screen print poster effect in Illustrator using a stroke grid system, then check the link in the description. Don't forget, you can get the colors I featured in this tutorial for free. And if you want to get access to the demos and sample colors, you can get them as part of the poster design ebook. The link is in the description. Well, I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. If you did, hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell button to be notified of more tutorial videos like this in future. Now, this tutorial was created for all my members of the GDS Design School community. If you would like to join the GDS Design School community, where we chat about design, give each other feedback, and where I set design challenges, you're all welcome to join for free. Again, the link is in the description, and I look forward to seeing you there. So until my next design tutorial, unleash your creativity, and I'll see you next time.